he touched her. She was weeping, and I just offered her, "Hey, like, would you like a prayer?" And she's like, "I would love a prayer." And I just, you know, I stood up in the middle of a restaurant. It was a busy restaurant. I laid my hand on her, and we just started praying. So it's Friday night, 1:20 in the morning. We just recently got back from a dinner. Me and my brother just went out for dinner, got back, and I cannot help but just to grab a camera and record this video and talk about the way God moved tonight in our lives. It was really crazy, and I really need to share about His works. And yeah, just so rejoiced and just give Him glory. So this whole day was good. So we had a event at church. It's for young adults in the evening, where we just come, we worship, and we go through the, you know, study Bible. There's a sermon, and then there's just some fellowship where we just hang out with one another. And I wasn't really even planning to go. So I worked in the day, got back, I went to the gym as always, and when I got back, I felt pretty stirred to go, so I just went. And when I went, I didn't even expect that worship was particularly good tonight. It was so good, I just really felt the Lord, and, you know, had this intimacy with Him. And when I was worshiping, just a few, this one song really stood out to me, what a beautiful name it is. Just, you know, the lines when it goes that you didn't want a heaven without us, so Jesus, you brought the heavens down. My sin was great, but your love was greater, and what can separate us now? And when I just was worshiping, you know, I was just like weeping, and it was so amazing the way just, I don't know, it just consumed me, overwhelmed me, I don't know. So the worship was just so good, you know. I really felt the Spirit. And also after that is, I think we went through the, yeah, we went through the book of John. The preacher mentioned that Jesus have overcome the world for us. And yes, He did. And as a result, now we can have strength and we can have power through Him. And it just dawned on me so much as I was worshiping these pictures, you know, of Jesus really suffering and dying for us and fighting the battles for us and winning, overcoming the death and sin and Satan and winning. And now as a result, we can be empowered for good works. It was so awesome. And so what happens next is I'm getting back home, and I live with my brother, and we usually on Fridays actually almost never go out to eat. We usually just have a takeout, or we order food to our place. But for some reason, we just went out. And also funny enough, at the first we wanted to go to one place, and then we tried going there, but we came there and it was kind of way too loud. It was like just like, I don't know, like just music almost blasting. It was like a kind of a restaurant turned to club. So we didn't want to go there. We skipped that. We went to the second place and couldn't find parking there. And then we went to this like third place, which we weren't really even meant to go or weren't planning, but we ended up there. Anyways, we sat down, you know, I was like super zealous for God. I just, you know, had an awesome experience with Him, was all in fire. Just sat down, I started ordering food, and I was just telling my brother about, you know, like just, you know, young adult events, the worship, and some impressions and visions I got. and how encouraged I was just, you know, to feel the power and just feel the love of God. Like, yeah, he brought the heaven down for us because he didn't want heaven without us. And what kind of love is this? And I was just talking about love of God and how it just overwhelms and consumes me in my heart. And I was talking about that. And then also I got another actually almost vision or idea that, because lately God has been, you know, like stirring my heart and just bringing me to like some places where I never was doing this before, but I would just feel so stirred to stand in the midst. For example, it's like in my gym. I've been going to my gym for like over years, but just last week I just stood there and I was, you know, I listened to worship music a lot and I just worshiped and I just started praying for this place, you know, for the Holy Spirit to come, to just, you know, push away the darkness, to open the eyes, you know, to bring the gospel to people. I pray for the souls, you know, and the salvation of the people. And then I got this almost imagery or picture of like that, even one of righteous man of, you know, of one child of God that goes into, doesn't matter where, he or she has power. And also the story of, you know, how God wouldn't destroy like Sodom and Gomorrah because of one righteous man. And I just know that like when one is righteous, his, you know, prayer of righteous man is so powerful, and like he or she can really make a difference. And that was revealed to me so much. And anyways, I was just sharing to my brother, and then you know, we ordered food came in, and yeah, so we started praying as always, right? And my brother was praying, I was just sitting, and then for some reason I really felt stirred to just, like, you know, like, you know, lift up my hands, like, and I think it's the first time I actually ever did it, because in restaurants I think I never did it, you know, I would just usually just, you know, bow my head down, but I really felt stirred just like to lift up my hands and just like, you know, to pray like that. And my brother prayed for quite a bit just because I shared with him, you know, all these good words of God, and he was giving him thanks and praises, and we were just praying. And as we were praying again, I felt like just so stirred with Holy Spirit, with his presence. And, you know, I started actually praying for this restaurant, for this place. And I like lifted up, you know, people and their souls, for their salvation, for their eternity, that they will know love of God, you know, that like they will encounter Jesus, it will touch their hearts and they will be changed. They will know, they want this one truth. And anyways, interestingly enough, as we were praying for some time, our food got cold at that point. And we finished like praying. There's literally was a lady standing, and she was one of the waiters there who work in the restaurant. And she was, guys, this was beautiful. And I mean, we were just like, I know, almost caught off guard. I was like, oh, like, thank you. And then she was just standing there and she wouldn't just leave. She, as if like, you know, she just wanted something. And we're like, oh, thank you. And then she's like, are you Christians or something? And we're like, yes, we are. And she was like, oh, me too. But then it just ended up essentially having this conversation that she grew up Christian, but she really walked away. And she also mentioned like how this week has been absolutely the lowest for her. Even though I remember her when I walked into the restaurant, I remember her. And she was so smiley. Well, it's her job, right? You know, to greet people, to welcome people. Even though it's her lowest week, I guess good reminder from this is to remember really to be like kind, and especially to people in the service industry, because it's their job, right, to welcome, to be smiley, but it doesn't mean anything. Some of them can have so much hurt and pain and just have the worst days or week ever, yet they're forced to, which actually makes it even worse. Anyways, it's just a kind of, on the side, we just always be kind and ask them, you know, how they are for real, and always maybe read the body language, right? Because people just usually say, yeah, I'm good. But then, you know, always lean into this, like, no, for real, like, how are you? Are you actually good? Anyways, going back to my story, is she said that, yes, it's been the lowest week and everything, and I just, like, felt so stirred, like, oh, she asked what church you guys go to, and we said, yeah, we go to this church, and she was like, oh, I'm new here, I'm not from here, actually, she came from a different country, and I'm not sure how long she's been around, but she's like, yeah, I don't really know any Christians here, like, go to church, I kind of wanted to go, but I don't know anybody who to go with, I didn't want to go alone, all that stuff, and right there on spot, I really felt stirred just to share with her, like, that she also brought, actually, by herself, that, hey, like, I've been meaning, it's been on my mind, that, you know, I kind of walked out, went astray, and maybe this is a sign of God, right, from God, that, you know, he's like drawing me back and just to come back. And I really felt stirred just to share with her that, like, this is absolutely is a sign that, like, God actually loves her so much that you know, this divine encounter happened like this, that she caught, you know, with her eyes that, you know, some guy's praying, and she, you know, like had the humility just to come in and to engage and to, you know, just to confess that, you know, she kind of walked away, and she has having really not the best time in her life and all these things. And I just told her, yeah, God, I love you so much. And I saw that she knows the Lord. She had an encounter with the Lord. She just went astray, and, you know, like we always do, all of us do sometimes. And I told her that I reminded her about the story of prodigal son, and that you know, the father's arms just open wide and just come to the altar. He's there, he's waiting, not with any cynicism or prejudice or judgment, but he like kept running, right, with the best clothing and an adornment like to his son, and he's waiting, and you know, heavens rejoice when prodigal daughters and sons come back, and angels sing and dance and sing praises. And I start sharing with her that she just started weeping, like she started, that's what happens when the Holy Spirit brings conviction, right? I know Holy Spirit presence was so strong there, and in her, like he touched her, she was weeping, and I just offered her, hey, like, would you like a prayer? And she's like, I would love a prayer. And I just, you know, I stood up in the middle of a restaurant, it was a busy restaurant, I laid my hand on her, and we just start praying, like, and I start praying, and words start coming out, you know, for God giving him thanks at, like, you know, for her and everything. And as I started praying, she wept even more. And anyways, where I ended up is, I think she wanted to come back, you know, check out the church, but I in this kind of cases, I try to never like take contacts or anything, but I just left my contact information. I told her, hey, you know, sit down and pray about it, and if you feel stirred, you know, like, just message me, and I'm more than happy, you know, for you to join us in the church service, just come back, like, check it out. And but I think it's time for you to come back. And just, she was so rejoiced and just excited about the whole thing. So I'm not sure, I mean, I don't think she messaged me anything yet, but we'll see. Today's Friday night again, there's one day until Sunday, but this is what's crazy, guys. This is a straight up miracle. I never had anything like this happen, yeah, ever. I mean, even though, yes, I am super new to Christianity, I was born again only last year, but this is crazy. Usually, you know, I try to approach people with either, you know, sharing the gospel or just talking to them about God, but God tonight just brought this person to us, me and my brother, and it was crazy. We were just sitting there and like so mesmerized and amazed. And oh, by the way, because when she came, we prayed, right? And she came, we spoke with her like for 10-15 minutes. All food kind of got cold, and I got so much like on fire and excited, and I lost my appetite really. So kind of the whole dinner really went out of the window. But who cares when the Lord is moving like this? Like, you see miracles happening like this when we just like said, we spoke about love of God, power of God, and how He's moving in lives and His plans for the city, and just, you know, for to save more people and for more people to know His deep love and kindness, mercies and grace. And boom, just like this, we were praying. We opened our eyes, and there is a person just standing and like really like pleading and like crying out for help, asking like, help me. I just almost got the picture like that her soul was just crying out, help me. And I mean, this was just so glorious and just so thankful that God is entrusting some people to cross paths ways with us, and you know, we can just further, you know, plant the seed and water the seed, and praying that God will give growth to the seeds. It's so amazing, it is so exciting, it's crazy, but it's not even the end of the story. God was not done quite yet for this night. So the person I just described, she wasn't the one who was helping us out with the table. There was another person actually who was serving us, you know, taking our order and everything. And we said, we spoke, we finished food, and this person comes in, and she, you know, we grab a bill, we kind of pay for the bill, and then I just asked her, hey, how was your night? And she said, you know, so busy, so tired. And she asked me about my night, and I told her, oh, I'm actually just, you know, coming from this church event we had with, you know, young adults. We had just worship, some sermons, and it was amazing. And then so conversation kind of started happening, and I asked her, hey, if she believes in God, you know. She said yes, she is like Muslim, but more of a cultural, really. She doesn't really, she's not devoted, she doesn't even really know much. She doesn't go to, she doesn't practice it. She doesn't live it, essentially. She doesn't live it out. But she said it, but at the same time, basically, she was so curious just about to learn more about, you know, like Jesus and Christianity. She was never, she has never, I asked her if she has ever been to church. She said no. But I saw she was just so open, and she was actually just curious about the whole thing, and just, she was seeking something. She knows that there is this God. Yes, there is a creator. There is a deity and who made us all. There's a creator. But she's not sure, right? Like, who is exactly this? There are so many religions and everything. And but she was open and curious, and surely enough, yeah, I asked her, hey, would you like maybe to connect later and, you know, just talk about it, and, you know, I can maybe answer some of the questions and provide you some of the information that you have considered or you don't know. And she was pretty open, so I gave her my contact information as well, and I asked her, maybe you know you could also invite and just come to the church as well and just check her out for yourself. And I think she was pretty curious and open, so she got my number. And to the point that one night God just brought these two beautiful souls who are seeking him, because you know how Bible says this who seek will find, and this who knock will be open. And I saw in, well, first person, really, she knows God, she just kind of went astray. But with the second person, she lacks knowledge. She doesn't really know much about life of Jesus, what does the Bible says, why it is the word of God, and you know, what evidence do we have for resurrections of Jesus Christ, historical evidence, factual eyewitness, I mean all those details. And but she is seeking, and I can tell that. And her heart was just, you know, was gentle, and it was humble, it was meek. And so I just gave her my contact information and told her, hey, sit about on it, pray about it. If you feel stirred, you know, just message me, and I will be more than happy just to meet up, to connect, and just to have a conversation about God, about, and maybe asking your questions. But anyways, guys, this is crazy. And we were so rejoiced with my brother. We got in back into our car and drive back home, and we just like play this song called Yes and Amen. And we just worship God, thank him praises to all your promises. We say yes and amen. Just so happy that, you know, like we could like partake in, you know, what Lord is doing, and he led us to participate. Like, and it's just so humbling. It's like, I mean, who we are, it's just crazy. It's like I don't have words to describe that. Like, it's not because of us, but because of him. And like, you know, how vast, how wide, how deep such love is that we cannot comprehend with our finite mind. But yes, it is just wonderful, and I wanted to share the work of God really with you, and to give him all the glory, to give him praises, and hopefully to encourage you as well, that honestly, we, even though we are so new to this whole, you know, like walk with Christ and like true relationship with God, but he's been just revealing so much to us that like, definitely, it's not just, you know, it's not that what you do on Sunday morning in the church. It's great, don't get me wrong, but that's only when you gather with your family, you know, for corporate worship, to, you know, to take communion together, to break bread. But this true Christian life, it's every single day, every single moment. If you walk in the Spirit, it's like this, God will just be doing these miracles before you, and you could partake. And it is so fun, it is so exciting, it is so challenging. But that's why Jesus said, right, that if you abide in me and my words abide in you. But the idea is, yeah, if you just abide in Jesus, you surrender your life on the, you offer yourself as, you know, as a living sacrifice on the altar, then God will just use you mightily. And that's why we are the branches and Jesus is the vine, and apart from him we can do nothing. But when we are actually in him and then we abide in him, you know, he said, right, we will be like a tree planted by the streams of water, right, and whose leaves do not wither, and you know, which tree bears the fruit in its season. And it is just the Bible, the word of God, it is alive, it is powerful, it is living. And you just see the word of God, the promise of God living out in your life practically like this, and you just know, like, he is so faithful with all his promises, and it just makes you more to, you know, to just drop on your knees and to worship God with all your heart, with all your mind and your soul, to sing him praises and just to love God so much.